afternoon baseball here on the show. Ought to be a good one here between the Washington Nationals and the New York Mets. Stepping into the box, Trey Turner, and we are ready for some daytime baseball. The 1-2. A very fine afternoon for baseball. 67 degrees here at first pitch. The 1-2 is a breaking ball that can't find the zone, and it's even at 2.
Looked like he was a little over aggressive there to throw that nasty curveball. Just needs to slow his delivery down a bit.
Fly ball out toward left center field. Under it is Mariznick, one away. Adam Eaton digging in next. In previous duels with DeGrom, he's a 333 hitter. He's taken him deep once. And he takes a cold strike at the knees, and that'll run things full. Weak grounder back to the mound. Reined in. And they won't have a play as he reaches at first. Let's see how this is scored.
The second baseman. Howie Kendrick.
To the plate now, Howie Kendrick. This one's down to third. Davis has got it, and it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw. Throw on to first, and Kendrick is gone. Two away now. Man at second here with two away, and that'll bring up the dynamic bat of Juan Soto. Here's the 1-1. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's 1-2.
That was some smoke right there. High fire right on by.
Late making contact on that swing, and we'll do it again on 1-2. 1-2. Here it is. There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball. Full count now, 3-2.
Boy, not what you want coming out of the gate as a pitcher, right? You don't want to have to show all of your pitches this early on in the game, but that's a quality at bat. And what does it make you do as a pitcher? You have to use a lot of your pitches, and the more pitches a hitter sees, the better chance they have to make good contact.
And another foul ball.
Looked like he was cheating a heater right there, a little bit too far out in front. Gotta find a way to keep his hands back.
And he struck him out, so he was forced to make 9 pitches that at bat, but he'll take it as the inning is over. Digging in, Amed Rosario. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Two balls and a strike to Amed Rosario. Scherzer has pitched north of 2,200 innings in the majors, and with an ERA just hovering around the 3.00 benchmark. A 3-ball, 1-strike count to the Mets shortstop. Fouled away. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out. Stepping into the box, J.D. Davis. The 1-1 home.
Back-to-back strikeouts in the first right here. Pitcher is setting a tone, pounding the zone.
And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there. Two away. So here's Jeff McNeil. No one aboard for him, and two gone here in the first. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball.
Sitting in a good spot right here. 2-ball, 1-strike count is yet to see a fastball. Have to be sitting on one right here.
That's a hit. Their first of the new season.
Batting four. The first baseman.
At the plate, Pete Alonso started to go around, but he's able to check his swing for ball three.
Even though he was fooled in the box right there by that pitch, he was able to keep his hands back, not overcommit, and stay in this at bat.
And this pitch misses for ball four. So that's going to move a runner into scoring position now with two away.
Michael Conforto.
And a fastball swung on and missed, and the side is retired. Now batting, Eric Thames. He'll get us started in the top of the second. The 1-1.
Two balls, one strike.
Two and two. Well, as demonstrated there, that's a tough pitch to do anything with.
Oh, you think? If you've got a good fastball like he does, that location can be really effective. It looks so tempting to the hitter, but making contact on that pitch can be very tough.
He froze him on the fastball there. Eric Thames is retired to kick off the inning. That nibbled the corner there, but missed. 2-1. An even 2-2 count to the Nationals catcher.
One of the best ways to keep a guy uncomfortable is to pound him inside. They're doing that, and this one caught the zone.
Full count now. And he misses ball four. Here now is Asdrubal Cabrera. First shot for him here with a runner at first now and one away.
Number 13, Asdrubal Cabrera.
And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
Little hesitation right there by the batter. It was great execution by the pitcher down and away, but that looked like a late swing. Could have been sitting on something else.
Now Cabrera swings and misses on a good pitch that time as he's rung up for out number two.
The first baseman, Ryan Zimmerman.
And there's ball two now. And he fouls this one off. Suzuki, the runner at first with two gone. Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Bounce towards the second baseman, but this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Full count still. Keeps fighting him off. The eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Line to the right side. That gets down, and the inning will continue. And this one bounds around against the wall. And the run will score as the Nats are off to a 1-0 lead.
Batting up, the pitcher, number 31.
So now to the plate, Max Scherzer. Scooped up. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Striding into the box, Wilson Ramos. He's set to lead off the home half of the second. Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it four strikeouts already, and there's your first out. So one away here with the bases empty. And up next, the big RBI-minded bat of Yoenis Cespedes. And that fastball's taken but catches the outer third. And this is swung on and missed. His fifth strikeout already, and there are two gone in the inning. Striding in, Jake Mariznick. He'll try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. And that's taken high for a ball that's full now, 3-2.
No pitcher likes to take the count to 3-2, especially when you throw it.
Got him looking, and that'll do it. The inning is over. Top of the third set to get underway. Digging in for his second at-bat, Trey Turner. He flew out in his last at-bat. 2-1 the count to Trey Turner.
Number
It's two balls and two strikes now. And here's a curveball that's laid off that time. It's full, 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. So stepping in, Adam Eaton.
The center fielder, Adam Eaton.
The 1-2 is a wave and a miss. He struck him out. Now at the plate, Howie Kendrick, 0-for-1 here in the early going. Count remains 2-2. Kendrick waiting. Now the pitch. And a foul tip here, but it's held on to for the out. Good work behind the plate, and the inning is over. Leading off the inning, Jacob DeGrom, and they'll need him to get something going here. Here now the 2-2. High in the air down the right field line. But this will land untouched. And he comes back with one down and in for ball three. Swing and a miss. Five straight strikeouts now, and there's one gone. So one man gone for the Mets in the third. And up next will be the shortstop, Amed Rosario. Oh, and he was fooled that time on the pitch away as he went around for strike two. Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there.
Yeah, and if you get a guy flailing at a pitch like that, heck, you're going to go out there and throw that same pitch until he proves he can lay off of it.
Throw to first will take care of him. Score it 2-3 on the putout, and there are two gone now. So bases are empty here with two gone, and into bed next will be J.D. Davis. Ball and two strikes, the count now with the bases empty and two away.
This lineup is flailing right now. They're having a hard time just making.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. Stepping in and ready for a shot, Juan Soto, as we begin the top of the fourth. Here now the 2-2.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball, and the hitter just fouls that one off.
And he's getting his money's worth up there now. It's full, 3-2.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as an offensive player, and your teammates are loving on you for making that pitcher work and battling it out.
So he ran the fastball by him for the punch out. Juan Soto becomes the first out of the inning. And they'll back him off a bit with a fastball in, but it's 3-1 now.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
3-2, full count. Boy, and they cannot touch him right now. Five straight strikeouts on the ledger, and there are two away. Now the 2-1 pitch. Ties him up inside with a good fastball.
This pitcher's bringing it with some high velo. You better get that front foot down early and get ready, or he's going to throw it right by you.
And there's ball three on a breaking ball that misses away. This is in the air to center. Does he have another 1-2-3 for the ledger? He does. Seven in a row he set down now as the side is retired. Digging in, Jeff McNeil, 1-for-1 after a single this first time up.
Yeah, guys, still the only hit in this game so far. They've been pretty well shut down. Guys on the mound have really much controlled the whole outcome up until this point.
3-1 to him now. Hard hit at third. Oh, and Cabrera bobbles it. And a flip to first from Cabrera in time for the first down. Up next, the power bat of Pete Alonso. Bases are empty, one man out. High in the air out to center field. Eaton's able to put this one away, and that's out number two. Now to the plate, Michael Conforto looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch outs will stick with you a little longer.
3-1 to him now. And this one misses inside, a ball he walked in, and they've got themselves a two-out base runner. So the runner at first here with two gone in the inning. And next is the catcher, Wilson Ramos. Scherzer comes set. Here's the 2-1. And there's that sea of orange that's become such a common sight here at Citi Field. Those are diehard Mets fans, and they're not shy about it.
No, Matt, they really go all out in support of this Mets team, and it's sort of become a movement amongst fans here in New York.
Yeah, it's a well-organized group, believe it or not, that holds several events throughout the year. They even take their act on the road to visiting ballparks a couple of times each season. It's been really great for the Mets organization. Outside, 2-1. All even now, 2-2. No runs, just one hit, and no errors on the Mets line score so far. A little late with the swing, but he stays alive. Still 2-2. And he misses with that one down and in. It's a full count now, 3-2.
For the guy in the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches and
threw it right past him. A swing and a miss at the gas, and that ends the inning. Now in the box, Asdrubal Cabrera, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. A 1-1 count now to the switch hitter, Asdrubal Cabrera.
That's 1-2. I got 2-1 to count.
High and deep to right center. Mariznick going back at the track. On the warning track, he makes the catch. One gone for the Nationals in the fifth, and that'll bring up the power-hitting first baseman, Ryan Zimmerman. Here now the 2-2. Is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. So bases are empty here with two gone. And that'll bring up one of the better hitting pitchers in Max Scherzer. Now the 1-1 pitch. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
Hey, this guy obviously feels he can move traffic right here. He's taking two big swings. He's trying to help himself.
And he will strike him out. 10 now in the ballgame, and the inning is over. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Stepping up to the plate, Jake Mariznick. He'll look to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Full count, 3 balls and 2 strikes.
You can bet they'd love ball four here. That gives the pitcher on deck an obvious bunt situation to move.
And this goes right through his glove on into left field. The throw pulls him off the bag. Into the box, Jacob DeGrom lifted in the air to shallow center field. Eaton comes on now, and he has it, one down. And the runner, not tagging, will retreat to second base. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Amed Rosario, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one. So a runner in scoring position with two men gone. And into bat next will be J.D. Davis. The 1-1. Popped him up. Zimmerman is there. He's got it to end the inning as they'll strand the tying run in scoring position. Here now is Trey Turner. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. The 1-1 home. It's a slider that backs up for a ball. Three and one to the National shortstop.
Well, this next pitch is a big one. The last thing you want to do is give a free pass to a guy that can run like this. He's a real burner out there on the base paths.
And this is going to be extra bases here, leading off the sixth. And he is in to second base with a leadoff double.
The center fielder, number two, Adam Eaton.
Into the box now, Adam Eaton. One and two now as that one's fouled off. And it's a ball and two strikes to Adam Eaton now. And he struck him out. And there's strikeout number 11 in the ballgame. Runner at second, one away. And stepping in is the second baseman, Howie Kendrick. And that misses ball four. So with one out, that'll at least set up the double play possibility here that could get them out of the inning. And the pitch misses low and away for ball two.
A couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat, trying to get ahead and put himself in a good hitter's count.
There's one, but they won't get two as he beats the relay to first. Striding in now for the Nats, Eric Thames, and their runners at the corners now. Here's the 1-1. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And nearly a three-run shot. Instead, it's a foul ball.
Boy, the Nationals could use a big hit right here. They really haven't been able to do much all game long. This will be a great time to get something going.
And that will get down as he delivers a big one here. It's a base hit. And they'll extend their lead even further as the run from third is in to score.
The catcher, number 28, Kurt.
Standing in now, Kurt Suzuki. One and two now as this catches the outer half. And now one taken by Suzuki as he draws it even at 2-2. Come set, now the pitch. This is popped up. Alonso has a play, and that ends the inning. Digging in once again, Jeff McNeil. A hit and two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame.
Things not looking very good so far in this one, but we're still in the middle innings. They're down by a couple of runs, and this would be the right place and the right time to get something going. The last thing they want to do is to try to come from behind and win this one in the eighth or ninth inning.
Good change up in the dirt. Strike three. And the throw is there to record the first out. So here's Pete Alonso. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
Two balls, two strikes, a crucial count for both pitcher and hitter. So, Dan, what was your approach on the mound in that count? Do you still pitch for the strikeout here?
Action pitch right here, 2-2. The last thing you want to do is to fall behind the count, 3-2.
Got him to miss the breaking ball there. Pete Alonso becomes out number two this inning. Now the 1-1 pitch. Waves and misses for strike number two.
Boy, he looks strong out there on the mound this inning. He's got a chance to punch out the side in order and against the middle of the order, too.
And he popped him up. And that'll get down for a base hit. the plate now, Wilson Ramos. This one misses, and that'll fill the count here. 3-2 with two away.
Some pitchers fall into the trap of getting in on 3-2 because they don't want to walk the guy. But with the base open, it's not the end of the world.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. Brad Brock is out from the bullpen now as he'll get the call here on opening day.
Number 29.
Into the box now as Drubal Cabrera. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point. A 1-1. Swing and he pops him up. Davis will stay with it as he backs up and puts it away. One gone. Coming to the plate now, Ryan Zimmerman. He doubled earlier in the game, 1-for-2 to this point. Here now the 2-2. Hit on the ground out to short. Rosario's got it cleanly. And no chance on the throw here as he reaches first easily.
The pitcher, number 31, Max Scherzer.
At the plate, Max Scherzer. Line towards center field. And he'll lay out to make a spectacular catch. Wow. So it's a runner at first with two men out. And into bat is Trey Turner. Now the 2-1.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters. So you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
The 3-1.
You got a full count.
Popped him up. Alonso in foul ground. And the first baseman can't get there. The next 3-2. Again, he sends it out of play. Two runs, five hits, and no errors so far for the Nationals. On the eighth pitch of the at-bat is the one that finally does it as he wears him down, and the inning is over. Here's the left fielder, Yoenis Cespedes. 0-for-2 on his line thus far.
You know, Madden, every team has that one guy, and Yoenis Cespedes is that guy for the Mets. Completely changes that complexion of that Mets betting order.
And he'll step on first for the out, three unassisted. Here's Jake Marisnik. He doubled his last time through. One out, nobody on. Counts even a 2-2 to Marisnik. And that misses there, so he runs the count full now. Now the payoff pitch home. High and deep down the left field line. And that's going to land foul. The next 3-2. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Soto is going to get there as he backs up to put it away. And there are two gone now. Robinson Cano will get the call to pinch hit here as we'll see what he can do with two out and the base is empty. Right there at the belt, 1-2 now.
That's a pitch he'd like to have back. You're not going to see very many pitches like that from a pitcher of this quality.
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Justin Wilson has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 38.
All set for the start of the inning. In now is Adam Eaton. He went down on strikes last time up.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Got him. And he goes down on strikes for the third time.
Now that second baseman, Howie Kendrick.
And that misses, 2-1. Wilson is adjusting to the new normal as MLB now mandates that relievers reach the end of an inning or face three or more batters before being replaced. And for a one-time lefty specialist like this, that's a big change. Ready with the 2-2. And here's a pitch inside, and that got him. So here's the cleanup hitter, Juan Soto. He reached on a fielder's choice previously. 3-1. A swing and a miss, and that'll fill the count at 3-2. Base hit into right center. This will kick up against the wall now. And they'll have runners at second and third following the one out double.
The right fielder, number 9, Eric Thames.
To the plate now, Eric Thames. Outside and low that time. Now it's 2 balls and 2 strikes. Now a foul tip, but it's held onto behind the plate, and that'll go down as a very important out, number 2. So 2 down now in the Washington 8th, and that'll bring in the catcher, Kurt Suzuki. And it appears they're going to give him the intentional walk here, so now they'll have a force at any base with 2 gone.
Number 13.
Coming to the plate now, as Drubal Cabrera. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. The 1-1. 2 balls and a strike.
It often becomes harder to hit the zone when the pressure starts to heat up.
Bouncer to the left side. Rosario's got it. McNeil at second to finish off the force play, and that retires the side. And that will bring in the former top prospect, Amed Rosario. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast. They could certainly use that right now.
And he'll break through with a solid knock here, his first of the ball game. So the leadoff man is aboard to start out the inning. In now, J.D. Davis. Now a swing and a ground ball for the second baseman, Kendrick. One there. First, and that's the very last thing they needed at this point in the ball game, as there are quickly 2 away now.
How about it?
So 2 are gone in the Mets half of the 8th, and that'll bring in Jeff McNeil. The 1-1. Oh, and he misses it. And the recovery is too late, as he's able to beat the throw to first.
The battle. The first baseman.
Into the box now, Pete Alonso. And he drops a change in on him there, and that'll run it full, 3-2.
Might have been taking all the way right there. That pitch couldn't have split the strike zone any better, and you can bet he wants that one back to the plate.
And the inning will continue as that's through for a 2-out hit. So now to the plate, Michael Conforto. High in the air out to center field. Eaton is under it. And that's the 3rd out. Jerry Spamilia enters from the pen to start the 9th inning, as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the 9th. Digging in to try it again, Ryan Zimmerman. So far, 2 for 3 in this one. The 1-1 pitch. Popped up. Alonso is under it. And that's the 1st out of the inning. Starlin Castro will get the call here, as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Pitch hitting for the Nationals. Number 14, Starlin Castro.
Rolled slowly down the 3rd baseline. But a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. Now Now here it comes. That misses, and we're even at 2-2. This one sinks low and a touch outside. It's a full count, 3-2.
It'd be great right here if he was able to work himself on base. You got the leadoff hitter on deck, and you know the middle of the order is coming up right behind him.
Another payoff pitch. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone. So the lineup flips over, and digging in, Trey Turner. He comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day. Maybe too much break on the slider, 2-1. There's a shin-high slider laid off for a ball. Here comes the 3-1 pitch. And, ooh, might have thought it was high, but it's a strike, 3-2 now. Now a ball lined to the left side. And he dives, but he can't make the play. It lands foul. A payoff pitch one more time. And he takes ball four, so he's on. And as you know, that often means the steal could be in order here.
The center fielder, number two.
In now, Adam Eaton. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. And they pitch out here, but nothing's happening. Ball two. Now a throw over to first, and he just manages to get his hand in. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. Inside with the slider, and that'll back him up a bit.
He's going.
Turner's on his horse on his way to second. But he won't have to worry about a throw. Ball four. First and second now with two away. Two men are on with two men out. Swing, high drive, left field and deep. Cespedes going back. A leap, but he can't bring it back into the park. It's a home run. Dylan Betances takes over now with two gone here in the top of inning number nine. Late now, Juan Soto. Well out in front of the breaking ball there for a strike. Hey, there's strike three. So we'll see now if they can manage to hold on to this huge lead as the side is retired. Austin Voth is out from the bullpen now as he'll make his first appearance here on the season. Now at the plate, Wilson Ramos. He comes in 0-for-2 thus far. And he misses again, ball three. Waiting his turn on deck, Yoenis Cespedes. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Breaking ball swung on and grounded to second. Kendrick has it. And there's one gone to start the bottom of the ninth. Yoenis Cespedes striding in next. He could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. Here it comes on 1-1. This one's down to third. Throw on to first, and the Mets are down to their final out. Ready for another chance? Jake Mariznick. And he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final out here in the ninth. Now the 1-1 pitch. And this is in the air to right. And this should do it. And he will make the catch to wrap this one up. And the Nationals move to 1-0 on the young season as this ball game is over. 5-0 the final score today. The Nationals took the lead in the second inning and rode that until the very end. Max Scherzer gets the win on the mound, his first of the year, racking up 14 Ks in doing so. Jacob DeGrom takes the loss despite striking out 11 batters. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.
high score for our ball game this afternoon. For the victorious Washington Nationals, 5 runs, 7 hits, no errors. They left 8 men on base. For the Mets, 0 runs, 6 hits, no errors. They left 8 men on base. The winning pitcher is Max Scherzer. His record is now 1-0. The loss goes to Jacob DeGrom. He falls to 0-1. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 55 minutes. Our paid attendance this afternoon at Citi Field, 41,922. The Mets thank you for your continued support and remind you to please get home safely.